U.S. population is growing older, and that means millions of women are going through or have gone through menopause.
And that can have an effect on bone health. CBS 2's Dr. Max Gomez has some surprising information on how to improve it.
Most women know that menopause can lead to thinning bones, and a common consequence of thin bones is a broken hip. And that is a lot more serious than most people realize.
But if you break your hip in this country, 21% of women will be dead within a year. I want to get my patients just as concerned about their bone health as they are about their breast health.
Dr. Stephen Goldstein is the president of the International Menopause Society. He wants women to refocus their health thoughts more broadly, from menopause and bone density to overall bone health. Trouble is, for most women and even doctors, that just means a passing grade on a bone scan.
At 48, I had a full hysterectomy and was just slammed into menopause and really afraid to get a bone density scan.
Michelle's scan showed that she was losing some bone density, and instead of medications, she turned to exercise with Dr. Goldstein's blessing.
And that there is a connection between muscle mass, muscle strength, muscle performance, and bone health. If you have low bone mass and any degree of muscle wasting, you triple or quadruple your risk of falls and fractures.
In addition, while building muscle, also work on balance. They go together to help prevent falls and improve bone health.
You know, bone health makes you think you're in control of it and you can do something about it. Osteoporosis is a scary word that you don't really want to hear.
Bone health is more than a passing score on a bone scan. Even then, you should be building muscle, maybe taking vitamin D and calcium, and sometimes osteoporosis drugs that help build bone. The goal is to prevent osteoporosis or a broken hip. Dr. Max Gomez, CBS 2 News.